Hi guys, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to cover our next adapter, which is Dropbox adapter. For your information, I already created a video about SAP CPI real-time example where I covered how you can use Dropbox adapter for real integrations. If you want to learn or practice SAP CPI real-time example, I would suggest you to watch the video and learn SAP CPI real-time example. The link is in the description. Without further delay, let's begin. Let's talk about what is Dropbox adapter. In SAP CPI, SAP offered an adapter called Dropbox adapter. By using this adapter, you can integrate SAP and non-SAP applications with Dropbox cloud service. By using this adapter, you can perform various operations like read, write, upload, archive, delete files operations on Dropbox cloud. This Dropbox adapter supports both sender side and receiver side communication, which means you can use this adapter to read and write the files to Dropbox cloud service. What are different applications we can integrate by using this Dropbox adapter? We can use Dropbox adapter to integrate different SAP and non-SAP applications. For example, in SAP area, you can use this Dropbox adapter to integrate applications like SAP S/4HANA, SAP SuccessFactors, SAP Ariba, and other SAP applications. Let's talk about what are the do's and don'ts of using Dropbox adapter. You can use Dropbox adapter when you want to establish a secure and reliable communication between SAP CPI and Dropbox server. When integrating SAP CPI with Dropbox, you have to use OAuth credential to establish the communication between SAP CPI and your Dropbox account. In Dropbox adapter, you can use scheduling feature to pull the files or resources from Dropbox cloud. Let's now talk about what are the don'ts of using Dropbox adapter. Do not use Dropbox adapter for integrations which has complex transformations and complex routing, because at the moment Dropbox adapter offers simple file and folder operations. And another point to remember is, do not use Dropbox adapter in integration scenarios like streaming application integration or real-time data integrations, because Dropbox adapter is mainly meant for schedule or batch data processing. Do not use Dropbox adapter when you need to have integrations based on data compression or data encryption, because right now Dropbox adapter does not support out-of-the-box compression and encryption. Let's now talk about what are the configuration parameters that you need to use to configure a Dropbox adapter. In Dropbox adapter, you mainly need to focus on connection, advanced, and scheduling parameters to configure your adapter. I'm now going to cover the basic parameters that you need to configure a Dropbox adapter. But for detailed information, I would request you to go to SAP official documentation to have brief listing of all the configuration parameters. In the connection section, you typically provide the credential information in terms of AOAuth authentication. In the processing area, you need to mention what kind of operation you need to perform on Dropbox cloud. Based on the sender or receiver type operation, you have to choose right kind of operation in processing section. And in the advanced section, we usually indicate what is the retry mechanism, what is the timeout, and what is the size of the file, and other non-functional details. Let's now talk about what are the known issues of using a Dropbox adapter. At the moment, Dropbox receiver adapter does not support downloading operation of an archive file. And this adapter does not support SAS token authentication method. And you may notice some of the limitations like file upload limits, file content modifications, and issues with access to shared folders. So that's it about Dropbox adapter. I hope you liked the video. As I mentioned earlier, please check out my real-time example where I explained the end-to-end scenario by using Dropbox adapter. I'm sure that will help you for your interview preparation and real-time learning. Check out that video and the link is in the description. And if you like the video, always consider giving a like, share the video, and subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching.